Rotary and the Peace Corps has several things in common. First was promote world peace and friendship. Second, it has a long-standing commitment to help people of developing countries. And third, there are over 8,655 volunteers working in 77 countries. Still better? Closer? Okay. Thank you. It's my pleasure to introduce a helping hand. Shannon Borders, would you stand up? Shannon is the public affairs specialist with the Peace Corps, comes to us from Dallas, but she is an endangered species from Colorado. She's a native. So it's great to have you. Thanks, Shannon. As you heard, there are several former Peace Corps volunteers in the audience. Sue Fox couldn't be here. She's out of the country. But there's really some other distinctive and Rotarians that are involved in our district in a process that is going to combine, hopefully, the Peace Corps and Rotary International on the local, district, national, and international levels. You're going to hear more about that as we go along. But it's really my pleasure to introduce a lady that I've had an opportunity to meet yesterday afternoon at DU and earlier this morning, and really talk about her experiences and what's happening in the Peace Corps. As you read her bio, she has four generations in her family that have been involved in the Peace Corps. Well, I come close. My brother was in the Peace Corps in Micronesia, and that's about 1,200 miles from West Samora, where Carrie and her husband served in the Peace Corps in the 80s. Also, I was in the Peace Corps, and then my son completed his Peace Corps service in South Africa this last year. So we're catching up. But the key thing is that serving the Peace Corps, she was very active in teaching high school and helped design a national public's aware campaign on disaster preparedness. For the past two decades, she doesn't look it, she's been directly involved in the field of public health, specializing in HIV, AIDS, we learned polio today, and child health. She was also a John Hopkins Fellow with USAID in Indonesia and assisted in the government in developing and implementing their first national AIDS strategy. So without further ado, please welcome the Deputy Director of the Peace Corps, Carrie Radcliffe.
Thank you, Larry. It is really such a pleasure to be here with you. I feel like I'm at the mothership of Rotary in Colorado, is that right? You're the originals? And you're celebrating your 100th birthday. Congratulations, that's really amazing. I want to thank a few people before I start, people who've been instrumental in forging this relationship between Peace Corps and Rotary International. I'm going to just mention a few names. Mike Oldham, who's your past district governor, and he really helped to create the Peace Corps Rotary International committee that is working very diligently to have a formal memorandum of understanding between Rotary International and Peace Corps. Mike, do you want to stand up? Where are you, Mike? Is Mike here? Nope, maybe he's not here. He left. Okay, he was in my previous meeting. Grant Wilkins is another person, Rotary International leader and early leader in Polio Plus, and also I know is very involved in the water initiative, and Grant is back there, right? He was earlier there, Grant. Yeah, thank you very much for your efforts. Sue Fox is not with us today. She's a returned Peace Corps volunteer from Liberia, which is one of my very favorite countries. I'm going to tell you a story about Liberia in a minute. She's in Egypt, I understand, but she's someone I really want to thank, and she's also very involved on that committee. And then my old and dear friend, Steve Werner, who really is the reason I am in Colorado right now. He coordinated my entire trip, which is no small feat, And I've known Steve for about 15 years when we served together in the National Peace Corps Association. And I can promise you that for 15 years at least, and probably longer, he has been advocating for Rotary at the very highest level of Peace Corps. And so I'm deeply grateful to Steve for all he has done. So I'd like to offer him some applause. So you are celebrating your 100th birthday, and we're celebrating our 50th birthday. So I thought I would start out with a very short 3-minute video clip of the real birth of Peace Corps at the University of Michigan, where President John F. Kennedy came in. He was actually on a campaign move across the country. I don't know where he was traveling from, but he only stopped in Ann Arbor overnight. It was in the olden days when you had to actually stop in different places. You couldn't go across country. You had to refuel. And so he was refueling at 2 a.m. and was going to just stay overnight and leave unannounced, he thought. But when he arrived in Ann Arbor, he found that there were 5,000 students gathered waiting for him. And just a little tiny point of history, you probably remember Tom Hayden, who was a very active anti-war activist. Well, he was the editor of the Michigan Daily, which was a student-run newspaper and very active in anti-war politics, but also in student, you know, service and community service. And he and some of his friends wrote up on an old envelope, they wrote 10 things that they wanted the candidate Kennedy to consider as part of his administration. And he literally sort of elbowed his way to the front of the crowd, and as Kennedy was walking out to the podium, he handed him this envelope. And there were a whole bunch of things on the envelope. But one of them was establish a youth corps as an alternative to military service that would work in developing countries. So he handed that to him as he was walking onto stage. And Kennedy literally looked at it, having had no previous thought of a Peace Corps, any kind of civilian service corps, looked at it and said, well, I'll talk about one of these things. And he was a little grouchy, because actually all he wanted to do was go to bed. But you can't ignore 5,000 students. So this is what you hear now. And remember that he had just 1 second before received this envelope.
Ann Arbor had its first visit from a presidential candidate in about 20 years early this morning when John Kennedy arrived from New York City. Crowds had been gathering since about 10 o'clock last night. The senator arrived at the Michigan Union at about 1:45 a.m. this morning. Some 5,000 persons were on hand to greet him at that time.
I want to express my thanks to you as a graduate of the Michigan of the East, Howard University. I come here tonight